Hello everybody, I hope you're all having a good day. Today I'll be showing you how to download and install the Jimmy Johnson Spotter Pack, which actually has real audio clips of both Chet Kanouse and Earl Barbrin, which is his spotter, talking to Jimmy Johnson during real race scenarios. There are two options to the spotter pack. There is one that has cursing, and then the other one is a clean version. But before we get into actually how to install the spotter pack, it is very important that you do follow along closely. This is the third tutorial I've made on this, and there's been a lot of confusion in the other two, so I'm going to be sure to be extremely thorough, go slow through each step, so do pay attention. Though, of course, if you do have any questions or run into any snags, let me know down in the comments and we'll try to get you helped out. First thing is first, you'll need to go to the D Warehouse website where you can find the download. As you can see on my screen here, it shows not secure in the top left, so you may get an error when you're going to this website, but you can just go ahead and click through and bypass that. Once you do get to the website, you will see on the left the JJSP standard and CUS packs right here. It is actually has been moved to a Google Drive, so you can go ahead and select that. You'll then be brought to this page, which will show you different versions of the spotter pack and an installation instruction and an information document, this one right here. You will not need to install the instructions unless you wanted to, of course, and follow along, because that is exactly what this video is for. This video is your installation instruction. So currently for me, as I am filming this, the most up-to-date version is going to be this version 7.61, dated 1-2 of 2025. You will want to go ahead and navigate over onto the right and click the download. It will download onto your computer as a zip file. So you'll need to extract it. You'll have to use your favorite zip extractor to take out the contents. Once it has finished installing, you can go into the top right and then you'll be able to open it up in your folder. And as I just mentioned 2 seconds ago, it will be in a zip file. Now for me, I use WinRAR to unzip my files. If you do not know how to do that, then I would suggest to look up a video on how to unzip files and what software to use. But essentially with WinRAR, you just select the folder, extract to, and then just click OK. And it'll go straight back down to your downloads, completely unzipped. Then once you go ahead and click into the folder, you will actually see there are two options here. One of them is a zip and the other is an EXE. I'll be going over both in this video just to cover all bases, but the first one we'll go over is the EXE, as this will actually be the easiest and fastest route to installing it with less confusion as possible. And then the zip will be a little bit more confusing and convoluted, but it's important that we know how to do it both ways. So go ahead and double click the EXE version, and then you'll see you'll have your standard pack, which is no cursing, and then of course the CUS pack, which that is the one I am looking to download. When you go to double click the CUS pack, you'll get this error that pops up. It says Windows is protecting your PC. Now, obviously you want to continue at this with your own risk. You know, I'm just making a suggestion, but to bypass this, you simply click more info and then run anyway. Then you'll be prompted with a bunch of pages. You can go ahead and click next if you want to read through all that. Absolutely. I mean, I recommend it, I guess. I mean, I don't know. It doesn't matter to me, though. I'll click accept and go to next. Now, this is the step right here that most everyone got fumbled on in all the other videos. So this is the extremely important step. You are needing to find your iRacing install folder. Now, this is not in documents. This will be in your program files. It will default to your C drive, which my iRacing is not located on my C drive. And I'll show you how you can find out where your iRacing is located. You will want to pull up your actual iRacing UI, go to your helmet in the top right, and go to account. Then after you do that, you'll want to navigate on the left and go to your options page on the left column. Then from this page, you will be brought here. You can go to about and then your install directory right here. This is what you're looking for. You can see that my iRacing is actually located on my G drive. So you'll go ahead and click that. And what you are looking for is sound right here. And then your SPCC folder. That is what you are wanting to extract the file into. So let's go ahead and go back to the CUS pack and do just that. So from here, it was on my G drive, so I'll go ahead and click browse. That is my C drive, which is incorrect. I will have now located my G drive. I have now located iRacing. I find sound right there, and then SPCC, and then go ahead and click OK. That is all you need to do, and then it'll automatically install it into there, and you can go ahead and click next. Then when you go into that actual drive in your G folder, iRacing Sound, SPCC, you will see that there is a JJ Spotter Cuss Pack folder in there. Then once you go ahead and double click into it, you'll see that inside of this folder is another folder, which is actually incorrect. You don't want this. This is another extremely important step that was missed on the other tutorials that causes a lot of issues. So you want to go ahead and go into that folder. And then in here, you're going to have all of your audio files. So click on your keyboard Control A to select everything. And then you'll want to click and drag it up to the very first folder, if this makes sense. And then let all the files flood into the very first folder. And then once that is complete, you'll see back on this page here, SPCC, we'll go ahead and click JJ Spotter Pack. And then all the audio files are now in the initial folder, and you can go ahead and delete that folder. I know it's really weird. I don't know why it does that, but that is a very important step. And now essentially what I suggest to do is to launch iRacing, select your spotter pack, and then go ahead and restart your PC, which we'll go ahead and do that process right now. All right, here we are in iRacing. Go over to Options, go to Sound, and then mine's already selected, but you can go to Voice Pack, and then you will find your JJ Spotter Cuss Pack V7 point whatever in the world you got. I have the chattiness set on high. Of course, you can change that and all that stuff. And then that will be it. You can go ahead and click Done, and then I would suggest to restart your PC. That seems like, for some reason, it has problems. I don't really know why it just won't work right off the bat, but after a good PC reset, I started hearing Chad Knaus and Earl in my ear and all that fun stuff. But now we'll go ahead and go through the process if you wanted to do it through the zip file and not the EXE. Now we're all the way back on this page here. So we already did the EXE, and if you don't care and you're already done, you got the spotter cuss pack all set, then you can turn this video off. You're all set. I would appreciate it though, you know, if you left a like, I'd really appreciate that. But anyway, now we can go ahead and go into the zip file, which is going to be another zip we're going to have to unpack. Of course, we're going to go ahead and do it with the cuss pack. So essentially, we'll go ahead and double click that, go through the exact same process as we already did once before, click extract to and select OK. And then it should go back either to its original folder that it was in or into the downloads, which it goes into its original folder. And then here, just like how we did earlier, we can go ahead and pull up, you know, if you go to just your PC, go to your G drive or wherever your iRacing is located, go to iRacing, Sound, SPCC, and then notice how I went into the second folder. So this folder already, it doesn't have like another folder inside of it. You know, it already has the audio ready for it. So we can just go ahead and click and drag and put that over there. And then I'm going to have two Jimmy Johnson Spotter Cuss Packs now, which is really interesting. But that is how you go through with that process. Pretty easy. Both ways are extremely easy. I mean, it's pretty hard to mess it up, but there's been a lot of people that do mess it up. But it's okay if you do. Just let us know in the comments and we can help you out. And that is how you get the Chad Knaus spotter pack. And that's going to do it for this video, I guess. So thanks a lot. Make sure you guys leave a like on it if it helped you out. If you have any other suggestions for tutorials or things you guys want to know about, let me know down in the comments. Thank you very much again. And I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. And we'll see you out on track one of these days, probably.